Until the war in Afghanistan, the Vietnam War was the longest war the United States had ever been involved in. So let's talk about Vietnam, because there's a lot of stages that we have to go through to understand it. For example, Vietnam, it was once a French possession. It was called French Indochina back then, right? And after World War II, when the French get defeated by the Nazis, and they're going to lose their empire. And we're going to see the Japanese come in and fill in that power vacuum. The Vietnamese, of course, hated that, and they're going to fight back the Japanese. But after the war, when the Japanese are defeated and the French are restored, they're going to try to get Vietnam back. Well, the French are not going to like this too much. So they're going to basically wage a war for independence that lasts until 1954. When the French are soundly defeated by the Vietnamese. So when the United States is getting involved in this, you have to consider the fact that we're sending men that are not even, they're not battle hardened, they don't have any experience, we're sending men against people that have been fighting since the 1940s. All right, so that's one factor in this whole thing. So let's look back then. In 1945, the Vietnamese that were fighting against the French was led by a man named Ho Chi Minh. And they were trying to establish a Republic of Vietnam. And he even wrote up a Declaration of Independence, saying things like, all men are created equal. In fact, he was inspired by the United States in terms of its Declaration of Independence. But Ho Chi Minh was a communist. He planned on setting up an independent communistic republic. Now, France, as an ally to the United States, wanted their territory back. And so basically what breaks out in the long run is a civil war in French Indochina in 1946 between Ho Chi Minh's government based in the north and the French and its puppet government in the south. So what's the United States going to do? Well, the United States, theoretically, we could do a whole bunch of this. We could have basically just said, well, guess what? We'll just let them decide. What had started out for us in 1945, 46, 47? Oh, yeah, the Cold War. Who was our ally? France. What was our policy in concerning communism in Europe? Containment, right? So to make it really complicated as simple as possible, the U.S. decides to help out France. We begin by getting them to get their colony back. This was our first step into this quicksand. We started helping France, and basically what we did is we gave them economic aid. Something like $1 billion between 46 and 54. They still lost. And in fact, they're going to lose a decisive battle at Dien Bien Phu. So in 1954, there's going to be Geneva Accords, where Vietnam is going to be split away from modern-day Laos and Cambodia and divided along the 17th parallel. Ho Chi Minh's government is going to be controlled in the north, in Hanoi, and there's going to be a southern democratic capitalistic government in South Vietnam, all at the capital of Saigon. The leader of the non-communist government was named Diem. He's a Catholic from the north, and he's going to have a very serious problem. Diem is not a very popular guy. But nevertheless, what was supposed to happen was there were supposed to be elections 2 years after these accords are signed in order to determine who's going to basically control Vietnam. Is it going to be north or is it going to be south? Well, so many people were leaving the north into the south. They were basically voting with their feet that the election never happened. Never happened. But nevertheless, what you'll see is that the Diem regime is going to become increasingly unpopular amongst the people of Vietnam. I mentioned that Diem was a Catholic, and this is a problem, especially when you consider the fact that Vietnam is a majority Buddhist place. So Buddhist priests and Buddhist monks would actually stage protests, but not violent protests against others, but actually violent protests against themselves. They would actually just douse themselves with gasoline and light themselves on fire. This is the kind of regime, this is the regime that would inspire that kind of protest. So you can imagine then that the federal government, the United States government, is really going to start losing its patience with the Diem regime as we get into the 50s and throughout and into the 60s.